The Simpsons doesn't usually shy away from making jokes which offend certain groups in society, nor whole countries. Some episodes, however, have gone too far according to these countries, and have hence been banned. I've already counted down the top 5 banned in the UK, so definitely check that video out, especially if one of your favourites is missing from here. But now, I'm going to count down the top 5 episodes banned in other parts of the world. At number 5, we have Blame It on Lisa. The Simpsons receive a mysterious phone bill of $400, so go to the phone company to straighten it out. Homer threatens them, causing their phones to be cut off. They discover that the call was in fact made by Lisa, as she was sponsoring a Brazilian orphan, Ronaldo, and wanted to find out why he stopped writing to her. As it turns out, he went missing, so the Simpsons fly off to Brazil to find him. They find the country to be football obsessed and have very entertaining kids' shows. They walk through the slums to find Ronaldo's orphanage, for the nun to explain she has no clue where he went. They have some antics exploring the city, but quickly their concern switches from finding Ronaldo to finding Homer, who got into an unlicensed taxi and found himself kidnapped. The family must scrape together the money to save him, but can't manage to find enough. Fortunately, at Carnival, they discover that the flamingo on the kids' show is in fact Ronaldo, and he offers to pay Homer's ransom. Homer had a good time with the kidnappers, but they still make the switch, over cable cars no less. Of the episodes on this list, this one had by far the strongest reaction, with an attempt to sue Fox over Brazil's depiction. Their portrayal of a city with slums, rat infestations, street crime, and kidnappings painted Rio in such an awful light that this would heavily negatively impact tourism to the area. In addition, people were outraged by how stereotypical and inaccurate the portrayal was beyond this, with things such as the conga and macarena having nothing to do with Brazil, and people speaking with Spanish accents, Brazilians of course speaking Portuguese. At number 4, we have Little Big Mum. When the rest of the family catches Marge trying to chuck out their hoarded, useless junk, they decide to go skiing. Marge chooses to avoid the slopes and instead rest in the lodge. A clock falls on her, fracturing her leg. She has to stay in hospital, and Homer being a useless parent, Lisa is forced to look after the family. Things initially work well, but as dishes build up, the house descends into squalor, even becoming flooded. Now incredibly frustrated with Bart and Homer, Lisa decides to get revenge, so mixes oatmeal and poster paint, and covers the two with the mixture in their sleep. After waking up, panicking, and concluding it must be leprosy, they rush over to Flanders's to get help. He sends them to Hawaii to get treatment, and despite the electric needles, they experience a lovely holiday. This episode was banned in Japan due to it dealing with leprosy. Japan had a history of segregating people with leprosy, so it was a sensitive topic that was safer to not put on the air. At number 3, we have Cape Fear. When Bart receives many threatening letters, written in blood, he begins to think that everyone wants to kill him. As it turns out, Sideshow Bob was writing him these letters from prison, and when he gets out on parole, they bump into him in the cinema. He attempts to threaten Bart, so the Simpsons then choose to take appropriate precautions. When Bob threatens Bart again, however, the family is forced into witness protection. They move into a houseboat, unaware that Bob has followed them. At night, Bob ties the rest of the family up, and standing on the deck of the boat as it floats down the river, asks Bart if he has any last requests. Bart asks Bob to sing the entire score of the HMS Pinafore, and Bob can't resist. They kill enough time to sail into Springfield, where Bob is arrested. This episode was banned in Germany. Why? Was it too violent? Too inappropriate to show a murderer after a kid? Actually, no. The episode starts off with Bart and Lisa watching TV. McBain has a talk show, and is introduced by a man in an SS uniform, who can be seen on screen for about 3 seconds. What I personally frequently forget, and know plenty of others do, is that Germans are probably the most anti-Nazi people you can come across these days, so aren't going to take Nazi imagery lightly. Initially, they banned the whole episode, but eventually came round and aired the episode with that clip cut out, it having no bearing on the episode. Now, why did I put the second most popular Simpsons episode ever only third in this ranking? I was incredibly on the fence, seeing as I probably shouldn't do anything so controversial, seeing how small my channel is. But hell, I just think the other two episodes are much funnier, and perhaps because I haven't seen the real Cape Fear, I wasn't able to appreciate it enough. At number two, we have 30 Minutes Over Tokyo. Lisa takes Homer to an internet cafe, but when Snake downloads all of Homer's savings onto his floppy disk, the family are forced to become more careful with their money. Ned suggests that Homer should become more thrifty in his spending, so he and Marge go to a mega savings seminar. They learn to shop at the 33-cent store in order to save money for a holiday, and then go to the airport without tickets so they can nab something cheap last minute. They fly to Japan and are shocked by the difference in culture, like a talking toilet and a TV show that causes seizures. When going to a sumo match, Homer throws the Japanese emperor into a bin of sumo thongs and gets arrested. Marge has to pay his bail, and when the final note of money flies away, they're forced to get a job at a fish factory. They catch the end of a family game show and decide to go on it to win a flight back to the US. After being tortured for a few rounds, they have to collect their tickets from over a volcano. The bridge breaks and they plummet, only to fall back into the studio. They then make their way back home. This episode was banned in Japan, predominantly due to Homer throwing the Japanese emperor into a bunch of thongs, which, of course, stepping back from the fact that this is a satirical cartoon, is incredibly disrespectful. I've placed it at number two, as it was incredibly wacky and a constant laugh. At number one, we have The City of New York versus Homer Simpson. Barney is forced to be the designated driver on a night out, but this drives him insane. No pun intended. After dropping Homer off, he decides to take his car all the way to New York for a binge. Homer has to collect it, but having had a very poor experience in New York before, is less than thrilled. After a sweaty bus ride, Homer finds his car, bombarded with tickets, parked between none other than the Twin Towers. Whilst the others explore the city, he has to stay with the car, waiting for the parking officer to come, with nothing to eat except Club Kalash. After drinking too much crab juice, he must go to the top of the towers to go to the toilet, but in doing so, misses the ticket man. Fed up, he attempts to drive away with the clampon, seriously angering all the drivers behind him. He holds up traffic to drill it off, half destroying the car, and having to drive home without a windshield. Hopefully my brief summary here hasn't drained the fun from the episode, but it's so funny I wouldn't want to ruin any of the jokes, so you should definitely give it a watch yourself. It would most probably be in my top 10 episodes of all time, though that's a list I'd have to put a lot more thought into. As I'm sure most of you can figure out, if you weren't already aware, this episode was banned because it contains a very sensitive topic. When it aired in 97, it was absolutely fine, but when the 9/11 attacks occurred a few years later, quite understandably, the episode was pulled out of respect for the victims of such an awful tragedy. How did I do with the ranking? How would you say these episodes stack up compared to the ones banned in the UK? Let me know down in the comments. Like and subscribe to let me know if this is the kind of content you want to see. And if you enjoy cartoons, definitely check out my other videos, as I make my own animations and would be so appreciative if you could help me kickstart what I love doing. In any case, thank you for watching.